between the years 1886 and 1900-1902, experiments were done by Helbig and Lehnert to show that light has energy and the light can have the electrons ejected from the plates. By that time, they were thinking about the light has a material nature. The explanation leads to that light has got material nature, and small packets of energy known as photons are emitted by light. And because of that, the energy is transferred to electron and electrons are emitted out. Okay, first, what was their experiment? The experiment was, they have taken a glass tube which was closed and it was evacuated. There was this opening, there was a quartz glass and it was fitted here. It has two metal electrodes, one we call emitter plate because this is going to emit electrons, and one is collector plate because this will collect electrons. Okay, so here there were source of the light which can give the light as per our requirement. These two electrodes are fitted with a supply of battery. Here is an arrangement which is a very lavish arrangement to change the potential difference and to change the direction of current. This is rheostat in the series, and with the change of this resistance we can change the potential difference across this. Now the direction can be changed by this commutator. This is positive, and if we connect it this way and this way, then this becomes plus, this becomes minus. And if we rotate the commutator, this arm which is like this, this contact will come here and this contact will go here. What will happen then? Then this contact will rotate and come here. This will rotate and come there. Now you see, plus, this has become plus and this has become minus. It is a very changeover switch, we all know about it, changeover switch, that is commutator, which can change the direction. Okay, so now this is plus and this is minus, and we can change the voltage. At any time we want to see what is the potential difference across these two. For that we have fitted one voltmeter here across the two. We also want to find out how much is this current. So this is circuit of the current. In this circuit we have fitted one ammeter which will give us reading of the photo current. What we call it? Photo current. And this is potential difference across the two. This is required in our experiment. Now, we are ready for the experiment. For this experiment, we have to understand few technical terms of the light. The number one is what is intensity of the light? And number two, what is frequency of the light? How can we change intensity of the light and how can we change frequency of the light coming from here? So please understand here, intensity, frequency, very easy terms. I have got a bulb here, 100 watt, it will give certain light. Replace it with 200 watt, same color, yellow color 100 watt, then yellow color 200 watt, yellow color 300 watt, remove it, put yellow color 500 watt, put it yellow color 1000 watt. What I am changing? The light which is coming here becoming more and more, but in the terms of physics, I will say I am changing intensity of the light. So how do I change intensity? 100 watt, 200 watt, 500 watt, and I am changing intensity. Color should be same. Same color. Now, how can I change frequency of this light? Answer, for changing frequency, I should change color of the light. Because different frequency gives a different effect, and that effect is known as color. So, when I want to change frequency, change with color. Now, I don't want to change frequency, but want to change intensity. Don't want to change frequency, so I will put the same color. Want to change intensity, go for higher bulb, higher wattage bulb. Now, I want to keep intensity constant, but change frequency. Can I do that? Answer is yes. Put 200 watt bulb, which is blue. 200 watt, which is yellow. 200 watt, which is red. In this, what is constant? Answer, intensity is constant and frequency is changing. Here, same color, frequency constant and intensity is changing. So, this is the method how we use the terms we are changing frequency. You should understand how we are changing frequency. And when I say we are changing intensity, you should understand how we are changing intensity. Practically, we need not to change the bulbs. Nowadays, we have dimmers here, that regulators of the fan, and you use that, it will dim or it will increase the light of the same bulb. So that is changing the intensity. But changing frequency, you will have to change the colors. So these are the two methods you have understood. Now, we start with this. So this is, in this, we are doing many experiments. What type of experiments? We will keep on changing intensity, see the current and voltage. We will keep on changing frequency of light, see current and voltage. And then we will conclude, we will argue, and we will think, and we will conclude, and that will be a new theory, that is photoelectric theory. So from the next lecture, we will do it one by one experiment and see what are the relations of the different quantities here. Frequency of the light, intensity of the light, electric current, voltage, and when we reverse the voltage. So many quantities are there and we have to relate all of them. So you must study it very patiently one by one. We see the relation between intensity and electric current here. We draw a graph. Very first requirement is, when we give the light here, there should be some current visible. If there is no current, then our light is not having sufficient energy. So we must choose a light which is giving a current. And now you see, we make a graph of photoelectric current versus intensity. Photoelectric current versus intensity of light. The moment we give the light, you see, initially, what about this? We keep them at a certain potential. This we make plus and this we make minus, but there is no current, zero. Okay. Now, what do? We give certain light. The moment we give light, immediate we see the current. So, When the intensity of light increase, we immediately find certain current and we get this point. Intensity here and photoelectric current here. So we get this point. Then we increase the intensity, we find that current has also increased and we get another point. Similarly, intensity increase, current increase. Intensity increase, current increase, and we get a graph. The shape of this graph is a straight line and that start from origin. This is the graph. Now this graph has got two characteristics which you should remember. The moment we start the light, the current start. That means, how do the current start? By the ejection of electrons, otherwise there was no current. That means, moment a small amount of light starts, the electrons are ejected immediately. Okay? Switch on the light, electrons start. This is a very important feature. And other thing, second thing is that these two are directly proportionate to each other. Electric current and intensity of light, it gives a straight line. That means slope everywhere is same. So they are directly proportionate to each other. And very important thing, what is the effect of changing the intensity of light? Answer, if we increase the intensity of light, the electric current increase. This is the basic fact. So, remember these two things. When we increase the intensity, current will increase. 100 watt, some current, 200 watt, double the current. 300 watt, three times the current. So, more light, more current. And if the moment we start, the current will start. Moment we start the light, current will start. It has no any cutoff, cut-on intensity. Okay, so this is the relation. Now we will have more relations, that is potential and electric current, that is this current, and how this potential affect this current, the photoelectric current with the light. So that we will see in the next topic, in the next lecture. Thank you.